I'm Ahmad Shafiq and I'm in Indonesia, the most populous country in Southeast Asia with over 260 million people and home to some of the most fanatical football fans across the planet. But a power struggle between the government and the local football association has seen FIFA intervene. And since March 2015, all official forms of football have been banned. No national team, no national league, and no beautiful game.
The one sport they only care is only football. Trust me.
We're not recognized anymore internationally.
What I called it is this the football tsunami of Indonesia.
Kayak udah nggak ada. Ya udah tertekan sedih semuanya udah numpuk lagi satu.
So I've just arrived in the capital city Jakarta, and it seems like despite the ban, football is still alive. From stalls selling kits to kids kicking a ball around the street.
Indonesian football is at halt because of the FIFA suspensions, and that is of course because of the interventions that are done by the government.
Our government have issued some with our FA. Our government freeze our FA, and FIFA decided to ban us.
It's prohibited to send to deliver any national team outside to take part in any international event.
The FIFA let out their suspensions because of one thing only. And that is the breach of the statutes, Article 14, which is interventions of any other parties, which in this case is the government.
There is no other option instead of interfering. Any club should have, for example, a tax document. It means they have to pay annually based on their obligation to the country.
The PSSI could not run the competitions, because we need a permit, the police permit, to run the competitions. This they block the permit for us to have the league.
Ada sesuatu yang tidak benar dari PSSI, pemerintah mengingatkan dan mengingatkan dengan keras. Tapi untuk membekukan itu bagi saya sudah terlalu jauh mencampuri urusan sepak bola. Gitu.
Because what we're doing is just appointed by the government to act as a PSSI and running the Congress or running the all the laws and the regulation, and we're asking all the clubs to follow the regulation.
But what about the transition team? What exactly are they doing?
I don't know, is that a football team or something? Does transition team included in the football family? No. Do they know how to organize football, and do they have any ideas on how football is heading? I don't think so.
Akhirnya gue bisa bilang masih mending bola diurus oleh orang PSSI yang bangsat, yang brengsek, yang korup dibandingin oleh diurus oleh pemerintah yang nggak ngerti apa-apa tentang bola gitu.
We want to wait until the PSSI itself declare to be reformed.
We do not have any communications in terms of a formal communication with the government. We have already lodged lots and lots and lots of letters to the presidents as well as to the Ministry of Youth and Sports, asking a way out, how to collaborate, how to get out of these problems, because it has been almost a year and lots of people are suffering. It's a million people are suffering. We haven't had any international matches, friendlies or exhibitions, let alone the league, the competitions that football in Indonesia really needs.
There is a football in Indonesia. We have a lot of tournaments. Since we take over the organization, I mean the PSSI, we have already have many tournaments.
They have like big competition, they have like big sponsor and everything, television coverage, blah blah blah. So it's kind of professional.
Sebetulnya gini ya, awalnya saya memang nggak suka kalau turnamen ini diselenggarakan sementara federasinya masih tidak bisa aktif gitu. Jadi awalnya saya melakukan semacam boykot, saya tidak mau nonton.
Selama bola masih diatur oleh pemerintah, haram gue untuk nonton bola.
The fact of the matter is we are still members of FIFA.
Hari ini Menpora cabut itu selesai. cuma kan gengsi dan proses ini yang, tapi Persija
PSSI have been around even older than the country itself. PSSI have been around since 1930. Our independence is on 1945.
Yang gue salahin ya pemerintah, fuck lah pemerintah. Pemerintah telah menghancurkan agama gue gitu, telah merusak agama gue, telah merusak tatanan kehidupan gue gitu. Fuck lah pemerintah.
Of course, football is a huge business, providing jobs not only to the players, and with the ban here, it's affecting everyone. From clubs to future sponsorships, and all the way down to the people selling shirts and food outside the stadium. No football, no people, no business.
Some of the club is like stop the contract of the player because they don't want to spend any money. They don't have like income from the stadium, from the crowd and everything.
Dengan tidak jalannya kompetisi gitu kan, kita melakukan pengetatan dan penyesuaian. Yang kita kontrak dia setahun atau pemain yang 3 tahun yang gajinya tadi 100 misalnya, kalau tidak jalan kompetisi kita bayar ada hitungan potongan berapa gitu. Tapi kalau misalnya
they are not getting younger, they are losing their time to become a national players, they are being a motorcycle drivers because they do not have the jobs that they are meant to have, the football.
Every matches they won, Persib can sell 800 to 1,500 jerseys. Since the competition collapsed, no business at all, no business at all. Even the guy who sell peanuts next to the stadium, he said everything is degrading 200%.
You can see how much Indonesians love their football and the crippling effect the ban is having here. The game is suffering, but maybe the real tragedy is the toll on the youth. That's why I'm heading to the west of Sumatra to watch an opening match of the youth tournament and witness firsthand how they're adapting to the situation.
Ini yang apa di Bukit Tinggi, kota kecil ini. Nah, dengan jumlah penduduk 114.000, ini rata-rata setiap rumah hobinya bola kaki, laki-laki perempuan. Persoalan di Indonesia karena kena sanksi FIFA ini juga sangat apa mengecewakan kita, ya kan? Ini harapan ini saya pikir tidak apa, kita harus bangkitkan kembali supaya anak-anak kita, bibi-bibi kita bisa muncul. Ini semangatnya yang perlu kita kembangkan. Itu banget.
It's really reassuring to see the passion and enthusiasm shown by the youth. But let's be honest, they have to be that way. They're the next generation of Indonesian football. They're the ones who's going to propel Indonesian football to the next level. You're probably like me. We take football for granted. We get to watch our team week in, week out. But just by being here and talking to all these people, the situation over here is just not how football should be. We're back in Jakarta, and for a country with no official football, we've managed to find a village game called Tarkam.
In Indonesia, we have Tarkam. It's like village against other village. So it's like an unofficial.
It's like one village to another village, between village. If we're lucky, well, we're going to watch a national player this afternoon.
Because the FIFA banned us, and players need some money to live, some of the big players play in Tarkam.
Don't you think they're actually risking their careers by playing here?
Why, of course. The club have the rule. If you're found out playing Tarkam, you'll be fine. There was a national football player when the football stopped, competition stopped. So he needs to play because he needs money. And then he joined Tarkam somewhere in Sumatra. He got a harsh tackle and that was it. I don't think he can play football anymore.
What are your future hopes for Indonesian football?
I hope at least in 2019 could be resolved. Yeah, it's gonna be after the presidential election. but then if the same government happen, let's wait until 2024.
Kelanjutannya kemana? Kita juga nggak ada
opinions that they are saying that you know PSSI should stand forever and we should keep the unity of the football together.
Bola itu harus bersih dari politik. bola itu nggak boleh disentuh lah sama sekali politik.
It's obvious that football and politics are so intertwined here in Indonesia. But when you got communities coming together like this, no matter what happens, the spirit of football and the game surely will never die. The sooner the government and PSSI settle their differences, the better. Indonesian fans want their football back. Most importantly, they need it.